Hello, everybody.
Hello,
everybody. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the February meeting of the Wichita chapter of the American Guild of Organists. My name is Patrick Harms. I am the organist at Blessed Sacrament Catholic Church, and I am proud and blessed to present to you today on our new Berghaus organ that was installed in September of 2020. So to get this going, I wanted to give you a brief idea of what we had here before. An idea of what the church was like prior to our renovation process over the last year, and give you a good idea of what the organ sounds like. So let's get started. Our former organ was built by the Kilgan Organ Company of St. Louis, Missouri. It was their Opus 7588. It was built in 1952, two manuals, 17 ranks. It was really just another organ that they had made. It wasn't anything too special, but it did its duty for 66 years here at Church of the Blessed Sacrament. It was purchased for $14,000 in 1952 when the current church building was constructed. It was donated by a parishioner, Tilly Rosenberger, who ironically, her father donated the organ at Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception in downtown Wichita. I think it was in 1910 for a total of about $10,000. So it was just the family business of donating organs, I guess. The prior instrument was fully under expression in a chamber in the choir loft. If you're facing the back of the church, it was on the left-hand side. We'll show some pictures of that in a second. In 2018, when I started this position, it was in a completely unaltered condition. It had had very minimal work done to it over the years. And really, it was just a tired, worn down, dusty instrument. Here's a stop list, kind of show you a bit of the composition of that instrument. It was pretty decent for accompanying a congregation, but either it was going to be loud or it was going to be soft. As you can see, it has a full principal chorus and a 12th there on the grate with a good sized flute, actually, and a dulciana, full rank of couplers, the swell. Several 8 foots there and a 4 foot, and the one mixture on the organ, along with a trumpet and a tremolo for all of that. There's once again, swell, divisional couplers, and the pedal. The organ had two 16 foot stops, subas, and a lively cadet. And then pretty much, I believe, the rest of those stops there on the pedal were from those two original 16 foot. And then of course the normal grate pedal and swell to pedal couplers. So as you can imagine, an organ in nearly original state 66 years later is going to be having a few problems. Of course, we'd had it tuned over the years and maintained it as best as we could, but from what I heard, it really, it was just a problem. Starting in the 1980s, it started having mechanical issues. But when I got here, it had all sorts of issues about all the time. I only played it for about 6 months before we said, you know what, we're not going to work with this anymore, and we're going to come up with a plan for a new organ. It had faulty electric wiring that would randomly turn off the power. Keys would stick on the console. Several parts of the console were actually literally just falling apart. There wasn't really any saving the console. It had been well used over the years. Several dead pipes were in the chamber. There's, I think, just about all of the leather had been cracked Maybe some of it had been replaced, but it was to the point it needed a full overhaul. We'd have ciphers regularly, very limited tonal capabilities. It had issues with winding. It wouldn't always be able to fill the reservoirs correctly. And of course, then the organ would be out of tune or just not have enough air to supply it. As I said kind of before, it really just had the two volumes, loud and soft. There wasn't any range of sounds that could come from it too much. It had an extremely ugly case. If you could call it a case, it was really just in a room with panels that opened up to the rest of the church. When our current pastor got here and he had mentioned to one of his friends that we were replacing the organ, he's like, oh, great, you guys are finally getting a pipe organ. And it's like, no, our pastor's just like, no, we've had a pipe organ this whole time. It just didn't look or sound like one. So those are just problems with the organ. We also had a large problem with the church itself. It had acoustic tile covering the entire ceiling and the entirety of the choir loft. So the church would just eat up sound. There wasn't much in the way of any reverb unless it was completely empty. So we knew we had a problem. The acoustic tile was, well, dirty. It absorbed all the sound. You couldn't really get a sound from a choir in the loft. The railing at the front of the loft was solid, so a lot of the sound would stop there, and what made it to the church would be sucked up by the ceiling. So just in general, lots of problems. So when I got there, we had a few conversations around some solutions for the organ. There was this suggestion that we just, you know, we take what's there. It's a historic instrument. We re-leather the pouches. Maybe we add a couple ranks. There's tons of room in the organ chamber, so pretty easy there. Maybe add a facade, playable or non-playable. A few conversations about covering the ceiling with sound reflective material. Some people really wanted to add some chandeliers for visual interest. It was very dark in the church, so chandeliers might also have helped with the lighting situation and maybe drawn people's eyes up and back towards the loft. The choir director really wanted to remove the solid loft railing and then replace it with an open railing and, of course, remove all of the acoustic tile in the loft and replace it with some wallboard to better reflect the sound into the church. So those were all kind of talked about and thrown around a bit, and we had started doing some fundraising, but it didn't really take until the church started what we call the Glory and Praise Initiative, which was to renovate the church ceiling and replace the organ. So essentially the church had a few different goals with this. For the organ, they didn't want this leather pouch issue again. They didn't want anything to do with leather and organ. Except for the reservoirs, of course. So they wanted to replace it with a fully solid state system. Then to save money, we wanted to reuse the existing pipework. Really, there's nothing wrong with the pipework. It was all very well made. It needed some help after being used for 66 years. We wanted to expand the organ to include some more sounds, replace the console because it wasn't doing anybody any favors. And potentially put up mirrored facades on both sides of the loft. So a facade where the organ was currently on the left-hand side and a new facade on the right-hand side. For the church interior, they wanted to replace the ceiling with proper acoustical material, add some new energy-efficient chandeliers, replace the choir railing with an open railing, and then they decided to tack onto that to replace the carpet under the pews. We have terrazzo floor in our aisles, which is a very good reflective material, but under the pews had at some point been asbestos tile and then some carpet that, well, it was probably 50 years old. And they also wanted to add new tile around the altar area, which was also carpeted at the time. To really figure out what acoustic materials we wanted on the ceiling, an acoustician came out and did a lot of tests. I heard it sounded really interesting. You hear lots of beeps and microphones and speakers everywhere. And they determined that we needed to have sound reflective material for the main body of the church, and on the two side portions of the ceiling have sound absorbent material. So that way we wouldn't get too bad of a cathedral effect or something that just causes the sound to bounce around and just keep bouncing and bouncing and bouncing. We, you know, reverb isn't great to a certain point. So we had these goals in mind, and they set a fundraising goal of $1.6 million to achieve all of this. So the organ bidding, we had to, of course, determine who was going to build us a new instrument and reuse the old pieces that were appropriate. So we contacted the Associated Pipe Organ Builders of America, APOBA, to determine interested organ builders who made solid state systems. As I said, it was very important that we didn't have leather that was going to crack under every single pipe. We had two different companies respond, and both of them submitted bids for a complete overhaul of the instrument. So really, to our understanding, all that was going to be taken from the old instrument was going to be the pipes. So bid number one was for a two manual 28 rank instrument. It reused most of the pipe work, but not all of it. It was all going to be under expression except for the facade. So I can't remember if I mentioned this, but the old organ was completely under expression. All of it was in a swell box with two different shutters, one at each opening, that were controlled separately. I thought that was interesting. So the first bid, it was once again going to be nearly all under expression. They're going to add some new mechanisms for the solid state system, new wind lines, some new pipework, reuse some of the current pipework, of course. As I said, they're going to reuse the current blower, which was in the basement and had a wind line all the way up from the basement all the way up here to the loft, and put a facade on the east side of the loft, the left side where the organ currently was. They wanted just shy of $1 million for this, which is a lot of money, but of course for quality work, it's appropriate. Organs are expensive instruments, as I'm sure you all know. So bid number two, though, was for a three manual 24 rank instrument. That would be wild. So a three manual 24 rank instrument with options for expansion later. Included would be a traditional swell box set back in the chamber, new mechanisms, of course, new wind lines, nearly all existing pipework would be reused. Some new pipework would be made. And then on top of that, they're going to repurpose some existing pipework that they had in storage for other organs that had been dismantled over time. You know, nobody had any specific purpose for this pipework. They were going to build matching facades on both sides of the loft and actually add a second chamber on the right side, as well as building a new console and all that. So this quote came in for about $600,000. So we ended up going with bid number two. We thought that was a much better deal in the end. So without further ado, of course, we accepted bid number two, and that is our current instrument, the made by Berghaus Pipe Organ Builders. They gave us a nice rendering of what the finished instrument was supposed to look like, along with our ceiling, because prior to this, of course, the ceiling was completely and totally flat and acoustic tile. Here's our current stop list, showing what's prepared for later addition and what ranks were reused from the old instrument. Really, it just kind of, it filled out the grate and the swell a bit and moved a couple things around. We have 16 foot on both the grate and the swell available. New principal 8 foot was made for the left-hand facade. I believe the first 23 pipes are in the facade. The Quintadena was one of those stock organ ranks from a different organ. The Gedecht is still on the swell. That was one of our ranks. The octave was one of our ranks. The Gemshorn was also one of those repurposed ranks. The 12th was one of our old ranks. The 15th was one of our old ranks. And Berghaus made us a new furniture mixture at 1 1/3 feet. And then, of course, hopefully not too far from now, we'll have that festival trumpet also available to us on the grate. The swell fills in nicely. They were able to reuse our Geigen diapason along with our viola da gamba. The viola celeste, you'll notice that it is a rank from the old instrument, but if you look at the old stop list, it is not there. That is actually our old Dulciana. They voiced it to match better with that viola and of course give it the celeste effect. The gedeckt, of course, the Geigen octave, I believe the Geigen octave was another repurposed rank. The Rohrflot and Blockflot are new ranks. Those were made by Berghaus. The Plangiu was the old mixture on the swell. The trumpet was our old trumpet. What Berghaus did is they totally scrapped the resonators and rebuilt new ones and used all the old reeds and mechanisms after a thorough cleaning. And let me tell you, that rank sounds nothing like it used to. The clarion, of course, is derived from that rank. And we also got an oboe. The solo is mostly prepared at the moment. There's a solo diapason, which is also the principal 8 foot in the pedal. And that is part of the right facade, matches with the left facade exactly the same, 23 pipes on the outside. Currently, that is the only rank of pipes that is in the right-hand chamber of the organ. When we have that festival trumpet made, that will also go in the right-hand chamber. So the rest of the solo, the whole flot, the traverse flot, and the cornet and the clarinet are all prepared for, and they will go in the main chamber when we decide to do that. The oboe is just the oboe from the swell, and it's also playable on the solo. The pedal, not too many changes here. Of course, we have that new principal on the right-hand facade and the octave derived from that. The sous-bass, 16 foot, is also the bass flute and the 4 foot flute. Something I was particularly excited about is we did add a 16 foot reed as part of the trumpet. But that is not included in the swell boxes at the very front of the organ chamber. I think the first 5 pipes of that low rank are full length and the next 7 are half length. So, but it still sounds really amazing in the space. We'll get to this in a second. I have some pictures I would like to share with you. See, start over here. So these are just some pictures of the church and the organ before any renovation happened. This is the choir loft. You can see the organ on the left-hand side through that screen. It's both of those screens there. The right-hand side, what became the next organ chamber, was a closet. Previously, that's where we had a lot of our music stuff stored. There's some really, really old stuff in there when we cleaned it out. Better close-up of the organ chamber. There's the console and the loft. You can, of course, see all of our pretty acoustic tile. A better shot of the organ console. Oh, and I should mention, a lot of these pictures are courtesy of Berghaus. I was able to get these pictures from them when they visited the organ initially to put together their bid. So they took some pictures at that time and shared them on their website with us. This is the electronics on the inside of the organ. We've come a long way. Another picture of that. And the one thing that makes me think that this organ might have had something done to it at some point, or those yellow wires, but other than that, it seemed to be completely unaltered. Here's the old pipework. You can see at the front, the trumpet there with the pipes. Of course, everything is stained that orange color that Kilgan is known for. Lots of the other wood components are battleship gray that they were painted. More shots of the pipes. You can kind of see the, I guess you'd call them the choir loft swell shutters to that and the door to the chamber. These are the great pipes of the old instrument, the swell pipes. Some of the stops on the instrument, of course, it was a kind of a key desk console with a stop tab, a rail across the top with all the tabs on it. Better shot of things. There's pedal board, not too many toe studs there. I think it was just a full organ and I forget what the other one was. There's an overall shot of the console. The bench wasn't adjustable at all, so you can kind of see that I have a brick under it there to raise it up a bit. Of course, we took apart the console ourselves. Berghaus only took the pipes and a couple of the toe boards for matching on their end. So I have some pictures of the inside of the console here. Shot from the other side of the loft at the organ. Gives you a good idea of how big that room was and of those vents. Of course, then there's the organ console completely gutted. I think a few people, I know we took some parts of the console and somebody else took the pedal board, somebody took the manuals, you know, a lot of these went to good homes, so it wasn't all just thrown away. So that's all the pictures of as it was. Let's look at some of the pictures of Berghaus constructing the organ. They start with a steel frame that the entire organ is built on in the chamber. Of course, the wind lines and everything go under that, and the pipes go on top and so on and so forth. Everything was made of new wood, just totally rebuilt. So there wasn't going to be any issue with old parts. Here's the beginnings of the console. Some nice shot of the joinery. More of the console components, building some wind chests and gluing those together. Another good shot of the console, adding the paneling. There's the pedal board. Of course, they came and removed all the pipes from the instrument. So here's a few pictures of them at Church of the Blessed Sacrament removing the pipes. There's the chamber without hardly any of the pipes. There's just those ones in the back there. Kind of took a lot of things apart. You can see how dirty and dusty it was. And it was, I mean, it was just a bare light bulb lighting it. Plaster walls, nothing special in there. A couple shots of the staging area in the loft for them to bring things down. Packing up the pipe trays. Back to their workshop, getting the console together. You can see the different types of wood with the stop jams. I believe this is part of the lower part of the facade. You can see some of the nice detailing on the console that they added to make it match the rest of the organ and fit a bit more in with the design of the church. Putting things together in the assembly room. This is their CNC machine. It's a router machine that essentially is run by a computer, cuts things to precise measurements. It's my understanding that most organ builders these days use these machines to make the majority of their cuts. It really helps keep everything together and make sure things just fit when they need to. Assembling more of the facade. And here's some of our beautiful orange pipes being fit. Some more things coming together there. The reservoirs being put into place. Some wiring. This is actually gluing of the swell shades. So they glue all these boards together and then pull them apart from there. Some sanding and then staining of the organ console. A lot of the final color of things right there. Putting up the facade, and you can see in the background here the swell box actually coming together. Wind lines were all made of wood. More of the console, some more console components, then the facade again, starting to put some pipes on it. Swell box coming together, looking more like a swell box. And there's both sections of the facade side by side. Console nearly complete. I believe they're racking the furniture in this picture. Some more wiring. There's the innards of the new console. Doesn't really compare at all to the old one. Of course, completely different mechanicals and electronics go into the process now. And there's the finished console. So at that point, they're ready for delivery to Wichita. If you think back to that time, they were actually closed down in Chicago for about 3 months due to COVID. During that time, of course, we had closed the church and begun our renovation process. So I'm going to share a few pictures of the church before and after the renovation. The organ ended up delayed a bit due to COVID, but in the end, the church was probably open about 3 or 4 months before that time, just with very limited attendance in place. So here's the view from the loft prior to the church renovation. And here's the view after the church renovation, very different. You can see tons of chandeliers, lots of light. They added the coffers to the ceiling. It's just a completely different space, really. And then there's the view of the organ loft the choir loft without the organ. We just had the piano there for a few months for some music. You can see the new organ chamber on the right-hand side, and on the left-hand side, that's all painted white. So it's very bright now. And they added some new lighting. All right, let's take a look at some pictures of the installation. So of course, Berghaus got here and they had to unload everything and lay it all out in the church. So you can see there's steel framing, the reservoirs, just a bunch of different things. There's a view of all the components laid out in the church. You can see the console in the back, some pieces of the facade in the foreground here, some swell box pieces there in the middle, some of the wind lines, some pipes, of course. The lift for getting things up to the loft. And here's the organ chamber. They're setting a few things up in there. And the steel frame, as mentioned before. And here they're putting that right-hand facade in place. Since there wasn't very much going on in that chamber, they started off by really assembling that facade. Of course, you can see we still have our Kelvin orange pipes. More of the inside of the organ chamber, the wind chests in the front. Those are for the grate. Then of course you have a walkway, and then that empty space in front of the swell box is where the solo ranks are going to go. And then of course you have the ranks inside the swell box too. There's the lifting up of the console. Some of those glorious orange pipes that you can still see actually from that side vent to the choir area. There's the back of the right-hand facade. You can see the tubing going to all the pipes that will play. And then of course the wind chest and all that for the pipes that are in the back to support the rest of that rank. I really like this because it just shows this is on the great walk board. It's really at the very front of the organ case, but you can't see it anymore because the facade is in the way. Just seeing this carving in the side there showed, it really just shows their attention to detail and their artistry. And they're very proud of their work. They also ended up labeling everything. So you can see this. It says Bombard 16C to CX, the Subas 1 through 12, some more of the pipes in the loft, the electronic components in the chamber, these are just inside the door. Another view of the great wind chest, Subas in place from inside. This is our rack for the 12 pipes of the clarion as the extension of the trumpet. Picture of the mechanisms. Here's the reservoir, some of the wind lines under the swell. There it is under the grate. This is the largest pipe on the organ, the low C on the Subas. Still is labeled with the Kilgan Organ Company opus number on there. And this is what the inside of it looks like. So it's really not much to look at. A good shot of the facade coming together. The swell shutter mechanisms. Some of the organ console innards. More of those innards. The facade coming together. And this is the grill that they put behind the facade and on any of the vents with that nice cross pattern. Another shot. And that's it for the pictures of the installation. We'll show you a few pictures of the final organ. This first shot is going to be of the couplers at the top. And then the pedal stops. And the swell stops. The grate stops. And the solo stops. Good shot of the manuals and all of the pistons. And the right toe studs and the left toe studs. A shot from the inside of the pipes in the organ chamber without any of the lights on. There's a good shot of the facade at night. And here's a good shot of, this is actually the cable that we can use to move the organ console around. So really the console can go anywhere in the loft. There's no anything restricting it. We have three different points in the loft that we can plug it into. And it's standalone. So that's really nice. You can put it wherever you want to for view and ease of access or anything. There's a shot from the exterior or the interior of the box to the church. some more of those pipes, the labeling on the grate, more of the grate pipes, the grate from the small box, some more labels, and more labels. That's the full group, view of the grate and the bombard. More of that subas. And here's the facade at night. And here's the facade during the day, which is about what it looks like right now. I'm going to play a couple examples. This isn't exactly live playing. I recorded this a few days ago, but the new organ allows us to control, to record on the organ and then play back later using the actual organ to play back. So here's just a couple selections of the organ playing, just to give you a good idea of what it sounds like. We'll start off with a organ concerto by Walther. Thank you.
Thank you.